Hello everybody, welcome to Brew Box. Today we're going to talk about Track TV. In this video we will discuss Track TV, what it is, what it's used for, how to register for a free account, how to incorporate it on your Brew Box. To start off with, let's go to the website. Alright, now on the website all you need to do is go straight to track.tv. Track is spelled T-R-A-K-T.tv. And once you're here, you'll get this screen right here, and it'll ask you to join for a free account. All right, so all you simply do is click on this button. All right, and then what you can do, you can join using Facebook, which is the easiest way to do. So I'm gonna just join using Facebook. See, I just joined, I already signed up, I had a profile already. Now what I need to do is actually incorporate it to my Brew Box. Now how you do that, it's pretty simple. Simply just go back, go check on the actual add-ons that you need. Now there are a bunch of add-ons that actually use Track. But the main ones I like to use is just Exodus Forks. So here's the ones I know we use for Track. It'd be StreamHub, Gersal, Covenant, FlexNet, Poseidon, Piranha, and DaVinci. Specto works as well, but since Specto isn't showing any HD, I wouldn't even bother messing with it. So what we're going to use right now, we're going to use StreamHub. Now all you got to do is click on it. It works the same way with every one of these. You simply just click on it, wait for it to load up. Then when it load up, and this one you'll click on maintenance, but the rest of them you'll click on tools. So I'm going to just go ahead and go to the ones that you click on too, since that's the right majority of them are set up. So we're going to use Gersal. Click on tools. Now I was saying before, rest of them are set up exactly like this. You click on it and it just tells you, give you the option, just go to tools. So then you're going to go to accounts. After you go to accounts, you move to the right and you go where it says track authorization. Then you're going to click right there. It's going to give you a website to go to. That's the website we were just on. Now you can use this right here, the sign up for account or to activate it. You can use that anything far as your tablet, your computer, or your cell phone. You do not have to do it on the actual box. I'm just doing it on the box just to show you. So don't get up here and try doing the box, because this is a lot harder doing it up here as opposed to just doing it on your phone or your PC. So this would be the website you'll go to, track.tv/activate. That'll be the website you'll go to. Now once you get to the site, you need to punch in this code right here. All right, it won't have to be case sensitive, because the simple fact that all the letters up here will automatically capitalize. So I'm just going to punch in. I'm doing this on my computer right now. So I'm going to punch in E10E55ED. Once I get it done, I'm just going to hit continue. Then it's going to ask me, allow whatever add-on that you're using, you're going to say allow Gressel to use your account. And I'm just going to simply click yes. It's going to say woohoo. And it should pop up on the screen. Alright. And now I have an account that's already set up up here. So once you get done with that, once you verify that your account pops up here, then you can go hit OK. Now I'm going to show you that again. This time using the BrewBots web browser. Right, so this is what I was talking about right here. This is what you have to enter. Definitely don't forgot that code, so we're gonna have to do that on a different add-on, so we'll get a different code. So you have to do this to each individual add-on, but if you only use one or two, then you don't have to worry about it. You just do it to that one or two add-on. So now we're gonna go to Covenant. Like I said before, it's set up the exact same way as Gressel. And there's rest of them. Only StreamHub have the one that has maintenance on it, which is still going to be set up. After you click on maintenance, it's basically tools. So we're going to wait for this to load. It'll take a little bit since it's Covenant. All right, there we go. All right, so we're going to go back to tools, just like we did before. We're going to go to accounts. Go ahead to the right. I'll click on track authorization. All right, remember it's the same website. Only thing that changes now is the actual code. 53E7A22C. All right, so that's the code we have. I'm gonna back out of here, go back in. And we're going to enter the code. You're going to simply go to track.tv. You can go to activate. Alright, and now we're going to enter the code here. Alright, so 523E, as I said before, it's automatically going to be capital. 7A22C. Alright, so that's our code. We hit enter. To tell me you can't find the code. Well, yours should work similar to this, except it should actually work. So, as I said before, I advise do not try to enter this on the actual box. Try to do it on your actual phone or your PC device. Either one of those will work great. So, do not try to do that on the box, because once the code is no longer displayed on the actual box or anything, then it will ask you to basically restart it again. So that's what you'll basically be doing over and over, trying to get that to pop up. So here's what we're gonna actually do. But now, we're gonna go to the favorites. All right, and the one we already have to know was Gressel. Alright, so if you normally go into any of your Cody Forks, you notice you will see something that says My Movies and My TV Shows. Now, the My Movies and My TV Shows, they're talking about the track. So if you don't have any track account set up on your device, you cannot enter My Movies and My TV Shows. Since I already have one, I'm going to click on it, and it'll take me to my section. Alright, so here's my section for track. Now, I currently don't have any shows on my list, so I'm going to show you how to do that. Alright, so this is how you would do it from the actual brew box. What you can do is simply go to the movie section, click on any one of these categories, it doesn't really matter. I'm going to go to the current year. Now you can also do this on the computer as well, or your phone, whichever one, it doesn't matter, but it's a lot easier doing it on one of those devices. But up here, and you can do it here too. So up here, all you need to do is choose a movie, TV show, whatever, and then press the menu button. Right, and this is now the new options that pop up. You get the track manager and watched in track. Otherwise you wouldn't get this at all. So what I'm gonna do, click on track manager, and I'm gonna add the watch list. All right, and you'll get that notification since it's added to your watch list. And then let's add a couple of more to my watch list. Again, to add it to your watch list, you'll press the menu button. If you're using the keyboard, it's the letter C. If you're using a regular remote, press the button above the number one. Then you'll click on Track Manager, add the watch list. There you go, that's your notification. So now what we're gonna do, we're gonna go to the My Movie section. And then we're gonna click on watch list. And you should have all the movies or TV shows that you added. Well, since we're in the My Movie session, it will only be movies. You have to go to the My TV session to add the TV shows. All right, it's taking a little bit of time for it to load, but it will be there. And there you go. Well, these are all the ones I added before. So the latest one, the last ones I put up here should be up there. There we go, we got It, add that, Kingsman, added that. As you see, I got a lot of moves that I have up in here. It looks like 194. Same thing would be up there for your TV show. It'd be done the exact same way. And this right here is a good thing to, a good tool to use, so you don't have to keep adding things to your favorites. Well, what I mean by that, I see a lot of people come up here and just check out their favorites, and you see it listed with TV shows and movies, like about 100 of them. So what I suggest to do for your favorites is leave that to add-ons, and then just set up a track account. So once you get this track account set up, it'd be a lot easier for you. You can go into the add-on, then quickly just go to your watch list, and it has all your favorite stuff already added in there. Not only that, it also keeps track of what TV shows you watch, what episodes you have. And this is my favorites list. As you see, I have 147 items in my list. That's the way that worked. All right, so let's take you to the website to actually show you how to do more. All right, since we already have it activated on our account, we can just go into our tracked account. there, what you can do is click on TV or movies, or you can actually just search for a TV movie show. So I'm just going to click on TV. And from here, this is how you will add things. All right, you have this check that will add it to your collection. The actual box will add it to collection. The checks add to watch history, and these lines right here is add to watch list. So you'll click this. Every TV show or movie you click this on will add to your watch list. You simply click down, look for the TV show. Now this has a lot of TV shows up here. And again, every TV show is listed and tracked is also on your BrewBot. So you don't have to really worry about that. So if you see it up here, then you know it's going to be on the box. And if you also can do that for movies as well. So you can search for a movie. You'll see this type in it. And there you go. You see you have the old version and you have the latest version. All right, and again, you just click right here, add to watch list, and it will now show up on your box. You can do that for all the movies, all the TV shows. Then after that, you can go to your dashboard. Now, the dashboard works a lot better. I gotta put some TV shows up here. More TV shows on my dashboard. Progress list. You see, since I just created this profile, this specific profile, it doesn't have anything up here. Okay, I have currently like 4 different accounts. Some of them are dummy accounts just to make examples out of. And some actually have stuff on it. Okay, so this is my normal account that I normally use right here. This is actually the one that looks like it linked up. So this right here, what your dashboard will look like. As you can see, it shows you all the TV shows I have up here, all the ones I currently up next to watch. You can see I'm behind on all these shows right here, so it automatically show that up there. And if you actually seen the show, you can manually mark it. Now, but once you have it incorporated as you're on your BrewBots, and as soon as you get done watching this show, it will automatically check this off for you, so you don't have to worry about manually doing it. And then it also will give you the upcoming schedule of all the shows that you watch as well. This is the upcoming schedule that I got going on. It shows me all the shows for the remainder of the week. And what you're also going to do is check out a calendar. And if you put new movies up there, it'll give you a release date as well. And the old movies, it just have that up there too. So I click on calendar. Right, it'll tell me what day that every single show I watch come on. See, this is October 19th. This is all the shows on my watch list. This is when they air. can see that pops up a lot right there. That's only because I'm actually using the browser on the BrewBox. If you actually do this on your phone, on your computer, that doesn't pop up. Alright, so that's the way that works. It tells you when the show will be airing from the calendar. So you can also check your progress, you also check your history as well. You can also rate shows and write reviews up here as well. Then you also can, if you log in through Facebook, you can become friends with other Facebook members you have up there. With that, you can share TV shows. You can see what they watch, they can see what you watch. As you can see, it's the progress that I have on all these shows here. Alright, so that's pretty much it right there. That's how to use Track in a nutshell. Remember, the first thing you need to do is register for an account. After that, choose an add-on that you want to use. And those add-ons are StreamHub, Gersal, Covenant, FitzNet, Poseidon, Piranha, and DaVinci. Any one of those add-ons right there, you can use those. Then from there, you go back to the website, or you can go to the BrewBox, and you can simply just add movies and TV shows. And also, we showed you where to find the movies and TV shows. It'll be on your watch list within the add-on. So that way, again, you do not have to go to favorites and save any of the add-ons up there. Not any add-ons, any of your movies or TV shows up there, where you can just save it within the add-on itself. So that way, you don't have to always constantly go into the add-on searching for it, because it's in your My section. I said, as soon as you turn on the actual box and go in there, it may take a little bit for it to load up, but it does load up. It's the My section we're speaking of again, my movies, my TV shows. And again, to add it, all you simply do, press the menu button on the show, and then you can easily put it into your Track. Now, the thing is with this, it put the whole show in there, not just the season. So that way you can, and then also it checks it off as you watch it, so you know where you're actually located at. So I'm going to click on watch this, because that's where we saved it at. Now again, it depends on how many shows you actually have in here, that's how long it would take for it to load up. If you got I don't know, like 500 shows, it may take a little bit longer than the rest. Alright, so we're in the movie session, so let's go back to the TV session real quick. So here we go, my TV shows, watch list. Okay, so let's click on Bates Motel. You see, it has all the seasons in there, so you don't have to go and start clicking on each season by season. And if you actually watch a season, what you can simply do, press the menu button, click watch and track. As you can see now, I have a check mark by season one. And it should reflect that as well when you go to the website. So now that I got check mark. See, well, I can just start catching up to where I'm actually at. And then from there, it would start then giving you an accurate response of what shows you haven't watched and what shows you have watched. And again, remember, as soon as you get done watching the show, it will automatically mark it off as watched. All right? So if you got any questions, please contact me. All right?